Hey guys, I thought I'd show you up front what we'll be making today. This is the finished product, so we're going to be making a semicircle pattern and then attaching the end to the other side of the dowel. This means that when you're tying your knots, you'll have to create an arc in your work. I will show you how to do this in this tutorial. Just a friendly reminder that this tutorial focuses on this pattern, not the knots used. If you'd like a slower, more in-depth tutorial on the knots used here, please see the description. Let's get started. I'll be creating an alternating pattern in the middle of my diamonds, but you can do whatever you'd like. I'll alternate between square knots and leaving the middle without any knots. When you tie your first diamond, start creating that arch. You will leave less room on the inner side of the arch and more room on the outer side of the arch. So you can see here I've left more room on the outside and less room on the inside. I will now attach my work to my dowel. Create a lark's head knot around your dowel. We will tie 3 lark's head knots total so that it is the same number as the other side, and then we will tuck in the extra pieces of rope into the back of the wall hanging. I recommend using both outer strands and one middle strand of rope to attach to your dowel. Flip your work over so we can tuck in the ends. Tuck the ends into the back of the double half hitch knots. I will tuck each end into 2 double half hitch knots and then cut off the extra rope. The ends that I did not attach to the dowel at the front of my work, I ended up looping through the lark's head knots at the back so that it looked the same as the other side from the front of your work. I apologize as this part is a bit hard to see, but all I am doing is tucking the ends into 2 double half hitch knots at the back. It does not matter which double half hitch knots you tuck the ends into as long as it feels secure. Cut off the end. Cut off the end. Cut off the end. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up below, and if you have any feedback, please feel free to leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe for weekly video tutorials.